EU, Cikgu Rashid. Dan kita ada permintaan daripada Tuan Fahan untuk pair GN.
Okay, kita ni sebab EU is a major currency. So, kita tengok EU dululah.
Okay, baik.
Okay. Boleh nampak skrin saya?
Boleh, boleh, boleh.
Boleh, eh? Okay, I think EU we have been boleh. Talking. Tak tahulah ada orang masih swing EU ke tidak. Tapi I think we have talked on the bigger time frame, EU bearish. And also we were talking about look for lower high untuk untuk sell EU lah. And then it has broken 115.14 punya level. And then now it's almost about 114. Okay. So I think we were targeting about 114.50. Okay. So now it's almost reach ataupun dah reach pun. Okay. Dekat 114 apa 40 punya level. Okay. So dengan kekuatan bearish ni, okay, I'm thinking the movement akan ada satu lagi low dekat EU sebab US dollar macam saya kata masih belum kuat sepenuhnya, okay. Jadi kemungkinan besar saya rasa akan ada satu lower high, okay, somewhere dekat sini sebelum EU buat another lower low, okay. So I'm expecting probably dekat 113.50, okay, ataupun dekat 113, okay. I think this might happen before end of the year. Okay, so that means before that, there will be a bit of a retracement, then breakout, then a retracement, breakout. Okay, so this will be the move for EU, I guess. Okay, when it's going to happen, I think most likely towards the early part of December FOMC, ataupun even before that, if any headline to a news that is in favor of US dollar, okay? Sebab US dollar nampak agak going to be very bullish sebab orang kata US dollar belum react lagi, belum increase interest rate, belum buat tapering lagi, tapi kita dah nampak kekuatan US dollar. So the moment tapering betul-betul dah berlaku, interest rate pun naik, saya rasa EU akan make new lower low. Okay, so that's on the Euro US dollar. Next one, GN. GN kita dah lama tak tengok.
Ya, yeah, betul.
Okay, so GN kalau kita tengok dekat kita start off dengan weekly time frame sebab daily ni dia kurang sedikit. Okay, so dia dah buat satu new low dekat bawah ni. Dekat 188. Okay. Sebab macam hari tu saya pernah bercakap. Okay. AUD dengan NZD is quite strong. Okay. So, and GBP was quite weak. Okay. Dekat tengah-tengah. So, bila dia kuat ni, so that push GN ke bawah. Okay. Tapi kita nampak ada some kind of orang kata pullback at this point, okay. So kita kalau pergi dekat H4, dia macam ada rejection dekat 188.50 this zone, okay. So I think for next 1 week plus ataupun few couple of days, saya rasa GN akan turun before the CPI news yang keluar hari Selasa ke hari Rabu yang tadi kita review. Okay, I think there will be some kind of a support kat sini. Rabu, I think it will break out to make a new high on this time frame. So saya rasa sama ada kalau dia hold kat sini, dia ke atas ataupun dia mungkin spike ke bawah ke atas. So saya jangka GBP akan kuat for this week, okay, and for the coming weeks. Sebab GBP saya rasa maybe the first, not to say first, but GBP will make a first move to increase interest rate very soon, okay, with the, all the news coming out from there. So I'm expecting GBP untuk ke atas lah, okay. Tapi sama ada dia datang untuk test this for second time before push out, atau ada some kind of, we call it fake out, baru ke atas. Tapi the direction still ke atas. So kalau tanya saya, GN buy lah, okay? Sebab New Zealand dollar dengan AUD kita jangka akan melemah untuk beberapa minggu akan datang ni. Okay? Okay, Bun?
Okay, baik. Terima kasih.